Hi, Ms. Collins here with another short video about setting up your computer to work with me. When we were working last week, the first week of school, I noticed as I walked around the room, some people were having problems because their computer program, Photoshop, was not set up like mine. So I'm going to show you some things so that as I'm demonstrating up on the screen or as you're watching my videos, you'll have your computer looking like mine, your screen, so it makes sense. It's a little bit easier to find things. But first, let me get myself out of the way. Bye! Here we are in Photoshop. And I just want to point out to you that this is the option bar and you can move it around. So if you don't like it up here at the top, you can move it here to the bottom. I like to have mine up at the top so the people at the back row can see what's going on. If you ever lose it, it's over here underneath Windows. So I'm bringing back options. The other thing that throws people off is my toolbox is this long rectangle. Some people's computers, it looks like that. So look where I'm clicking. There's this little double arrow here. When I click on it, it's long, short, long. It's on and off. Okay? Have yours long. Another thing is we're going to be measuring a lot of things on the computer. It is digital art. Digital art means numbers, digital numbers. So I'd like for you to have, under the view menu, I'd like for you to have the ruler showing. Notice you could also do, oh, look at that little funny symbol there, that little clover. That means command. So if you do command R, the rulers will show up. Let me do that again. Rulers off, view, rulers on. Or I'm not doing the menu, I'm just doing command R on my keyboard. Now, if you put your cursor, that black arrow, not this is a paintbrush, right? If you put your cursor, we can see the black arrow on the ruler, click, hold, and drag, you can pull out a guideline to help you measure things. So if you look at the ruler up here at the top, I'm setting it on 2. I'm bringing back the black cursor, clicking on the ruler, dragging down, and now I have a box that I know is exactly 2 by 2. Now some people have problems seeing this color. This is called cyan on these guides here. So if you go up to the Photoshop menu, choose Photoshop Preferences, Guides, Grids, and Slices, you can change that guide color to something that shows up better for your eyesight. Here is red. Red on top of red doesn't work so good. Sometimes I come in and change this depending on what my painting looks like. Blue shows up really good. How about on your computer? You choose the colors that you want. So okay to that. Now, I notice that as I set up and had people paint, some of their paint was not coming in like it looks on the color picker. Why is that? Because the option bar has something other than 100% opacity. Now, to make it easier for everybody just to follow me along at the beginning of this semester, let's reset all of the tools to their factory settings. And it's real easy. I'm going to go up here. I'm going to do File. I'm coming over here and clicking on the Move tool. Right here, the top one on the list, it shows up here on the option bar. Click on its arrow. Click on that little arrow there. There's another little arrow that shows up. Click and reset all tools. It's going to take a little bit. Oh, this window's going to come up. You click OK. Might have to think about it a little bit. I'm going to click on the bar to get out of that. Now here's the color in the color picker. If I pick up the paintbrush, do I get, oh look, even the size changed. So I'm back to factory settings and your machine will be set up like mine. Oh, those pesky guidelines. I want to get rid of those. View, clear guides. Well, that's it. Good luck setting up your machine. Bye-bye.